Good morning, students. Let us have the revision. Whatever the thing we have seen yesterday, we will come, go up, and then we should go further to Tun, the place. And we have to see, along with this reading, the grammar or the last portion of this lesson. See, I will take your 5 minutes only and I will try to read this passage as fast as I can. See, page number 84. This portion, now I am reading to you. 84 and 85. Our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days. The Portuguese and their famous loaf of bread. Those eaten of loaves might have vanished, but the maker are still there. Bakers are still there. We still have among us the witnesses, the moulders, and those who bake the loaves. Those age-old, time-tested furnaces we still exist. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. The thud and the jingle of the traditional baker bamboo, heralding his arrival in the morning, can still be heard in some places. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. These bakers are, even today, known as padar in Goa. During our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion and guide. He used to come at least twice a day. Once when he set out in the morning on his sailing round, and then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket, the jangling turn of his bamboo woke us from sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it from the law of blow? Not at all. The loaf were drawn by some basking or basking, the maid servant of the house. What we longed for were those the bread tidings which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread or special bake. The baker made his just meat. Musical entry on the scene with clang clang round. Let me continue it like this. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the clang clang sound of his special made bamboo straw. One hand supported the basket on his head and the other banged the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. We kids would be pushed aside with a mild review and a loaf would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench on the parapet and peep into the basket. Somehow, I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves for the elders bangle for the children. Then we did not even care to brush or dip or wash our mouth properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushes teeth. Hot tea would wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. Page number 85, 86. Yes, please. And 87. And now page number 87 is going on. Manage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as gold. Manage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as the bowl. Just as a party or feast loses charm without bread, not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for villages. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter-in-law's, of her daughter's engagement. Cake and must for Christmas as well as other festivals. Thus, the presence of the baker furnaces in the village is still absolutely essential. The baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as a kabai. It was a single piece long from reaching down to the knees. In our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trousers which were shorter than full length one and longer than half pants. Even today, anyone who wears a half pant which reaches just below the knees invites the comment that he is dressed like a peddler. The baker usually collected his bill at the end of the month. Monthly account used to be recorded on the wall in pencil. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. The baker and his family never starved. His family and his servant always looked happy and prosperous. Their plump physique was an open testimony of this. Even today, any person with jackfruit like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. Now, oral comprehension check. Match the following and what is a must. You have to arrange as marriage gift. What is cake and sweet bread and sandwich? What is as a marriage gift? The answer is given a bread like this. For a party or a feast, for a daughter's engagement, what is sandwich? In this way, match this. And now, what is page number 88? Thinking about the text, which of the statements are connected? The peddler was an important person in the village in old days. That is correct. Peddler still exists in Goa village. Correct. The peddler went away with Portugal. Wrong. Fourth, the peddlers continued to wear a single piece long frock. Yes. Bread and cakes were an integral part of Goan life in the old days. Correct. Traditional bread baking is still a very profitable business. Right, correct. Peddler and their family start in the present time. No, wrong. Now take the right answer. What is tone of author when he says the following? The thud and the jingle of traditional baker bamboo can still be heard in some places. That is nostalgic memory of the past. Second, maybe other is not alive, but the sun still carry on the fan. feminine professional that is hopeful. I still recall the typical fragrance of those love that is nostalgic. The tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea to wash and clean everything so nicely. After all, that is funny. Cake and pudding are a must for Christmas as well as other festival. That is a fact, matter of fact. Last, the baker and his family never starve. They always look happy and prosperous. That is matter of fact. In this way, you should go on doing all this work. Today, let me start with this place. Unfortunately, this has the press. Writing Palette Art is deleted in this year. But this is a description of this place. Come on. If you come across anything good, please tell me. Second part. Of course, this book is second part of the lesson. Let me go ahead. Midway between Mysore, midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sees a piece of heaven that must have dictated from the kingdom of God. This land of rolling hill is inhabited by a proud race of martial men, beautiful women, and wild creation. See the introduction to the place. Beautiful. Means midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sees a piece of heaven that must have been taken from the kingdom of God. This land of rolling hills is inhabited or located by a proud race of martial men and beautiful women and wild creatures. Kodgo, the smallest district of Karnataka, is home to evergreen rainforest, spices and coffee plantation. Evergreen rainforest cover 30% of the district. During the monsoon, it covers enough to keep many visitors away. The reason of joy commences from September and continues in March. The weather is perfect with some shower thrown in some good measure. The air breathe of innovating coffee. Coffee estate and Coronal Mangalore stand tucked under three canopies in prime concern. The first independent people of Kut are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. As one story goes, a part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled there when it has become impractical. These people married among the local, and their culture is apparent in the martial traditional marriage and religious rites, which are distinct from Hindu mainstream. The theory of our origin draws support from the long back coat with an embroidered vest belt worn by these Kodgos, known as Kupiya. It resembled the kufiya worn by Arab and the Kurd. Kurd have a traditional hospitality, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of wagons related to their sons and father. The Kurd regiment is one of the most The Coat Regiment is one of the most decorated in Indian Army, and the first chief of Indian Army, General Karimpa, was a Coot. Even now, these Coots are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. The river Kaveri obtained its water from the hill and forest of Coot. Mahishya, a large fresh water fish, drowned in these water. Fisher King died for their catch. White squirrel and langur drop were surely eaten through for the sake of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect in clear water. Elephant enjoy being bathed and scrambled in river by their burrow. The most land-back individual became converted to the life of high energy adventure with rafting, canoeing, rafting, rock climbing, and mountain biking, and numerous walking stroll in this region are favoring with trackers. Birds, bees, butterflies are there to give you company. Then Nashaki, Malha, Squirrel, Langur, and Splendor Loris keep a watchful eye from their campfire. I do, however, prefer to stay aside for wild elephant. The climb to the Brahmagiri is bring you into the panoramic view of entire misty lands of Coot. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nagardham. Running into this mound from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Balakut is a bonus. The monk in red, orange, and yellow robes are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered, and visitors searching for the heart and soul of right here in Coot. This is just information about that place, and this place is maybe also called what? It is also leaflet information about place, and that information is in the correct way. So what is we should go, we should have all see here at the gate. In this way, here we stop. In the next place, we will try to complete this lesson. I think if you read this again, you will get all information about this leaf, or it is in the form of leaflet. I hope that you might have understood it. Thank you.